Hey Barrett, nice to have you here in our Schüker Arena. I will give you, for the beginning, some short questions, two options for you, and you can tell me what's your favorite. First of all, I start, of course, with your name, Barrett or Jacob?
Barrett.
Barrett, I knew this, so hi Barrett. This interview, in English or in German?
In English.
English?
Yeah.
How is your German?
My understanding is definitely better, but my speaking is very difficult.
Let's move on in English. Mm-hmm. Danish food or German food?
Danish.
What's your favorite Danish food?
My favorite Danish food? I don't know the name in English, but if you want it in Danish, I can say it. Stikflæsk med persillesauce.
Okay, we will Google that for
you.
Snowy or sunny?
Sunny.
Winning 2-1 with scoring a goal or winning 1-0 with a clean sheet?
That was tough because I don't score that often, so of course I would like to score, but for a defender it's so nice that you have a clean sheet, so I think I'll go with a clean sheet this time.
And then Tego
will not
scream at you.
Yeah. For sure.
Volbeat or the Olsen brothers?
The Olsen brothers.
The beach or the hills?
The beach.
The Danish beach or the Spanish beach?
The Spanish beach. In Denmark, yeah, the beaches are okay, but prefer the Spanish.
A dog or a cat?
A dog, definitely.
You have one?
Yeah, I have one.
How is he called?
Simba.
Simba, oh, nice name. Michael Laudrup or Ebbe Sand?
Michael Laudrup.
Is there any other Danish player you would pick?
In front of him?
Yeah.
No. He's the legend. Yeah, for sure.
Nice. Let's look at our Danish legend here in Bielefeld. Now you are here for half a year. What was the, for you, most surprising thing in Bielefeld?
The most surprising thing.
You did not expect in that half a year.
That is, if you want something, let's say an example, if you need a bank account, then you need to sign 20,000 papers to get that bank account. Here, every time there's a lot of rules, and every time you want something, then you need to sign. And that was quite a... I've heard about it before, but when I moved here, that was crazy. Also with the apartment we had to sign so many things. So I think that would be it.
Yeah, typical German, I guess.
Exactly.
And how does it feel for you to move away from home? I mean, it's also in pandemic, very crazy times. Do you miss Denmark sometimes?
Yeah, of course I miss Denmark. I miss my family also. For me is when I lived in Odense, I had 2 hours to my hometown, and when we had a day off, there was the possibility. Here there's no possibility to go home because I have around 7-8 hours each way. But It's not that I really, really can't enjoy it here, because for sure I think it's nice that my family is here, my girlfriend and my dog, and the teammates here around the team is also really, really nice. So for me, it's okay, but of course I miss Denmark.
I think that's okay. But did you already found some friends on the team?
Yeah, of course, they have been really, really nice, and we make some jokes with each other. And now we also start to play online on PlayStation, and that's nice.
That's a good connection, yeah.
For sure.
You had, in the first half of the year, a very tough time with an injury, with 5 games in a row where you have not been in the squad. Did you change something for yourself to come back that strong?
No, I won't say that, but of course it's difficult when you have something that provocates your mind. For me, that was the injury, and I really tried to keep going, but it was really, really difficult for me because I always had the pain in the back of my head. And on top of that, a lot of new things for me. Like I said before, also with a new house for my girlfriend also. We had a lot of things outside the pitch. And I think it's quite normal that you need some time to get settled. And also when you're coming home from football, that you have a home there, that you don't have to buy some new furniture or sign some new papers, or three or four guys have to come in the house because something's wrong. And so now everything are easy. My injury is gone and I feel really, really, really strong. So that's make it so much more easy for me, for sure.
What was the best moment with Armenia for you in the first 6 months?
The best moment?
Yeah, the best moment. Yeah, now we talked about something bad, now we need some good things.
Yeah, of course. The best moment, I think, was when we beat Stuttgart out here. Because I didn't know that, but I heard that when we moved up last year, they said some bad things about the club, and they couldn't understand how they could win the second Bundesliga and so on. And we were speaking about it before the game also, that the coach really liked to come out after the game and say something back. And when we won 3-0, it was a really nice feeling, and also here, for sure.
And your first assist, of course.
Yeah, of course. That was also nice.
Now that we've had half of the season, do you think we will have more experience and will be stronger in the second half?
Yes, of course. Last year, in second Bundesliga, everything went so well. And now we were in the first league. And not only for me as a new player, but I also think for the players who was here last year, is a total another thing. We can't do the same things like they did last year. The pressure is much higher. The play goes much faster also. But of course, now we know the things a little bit better, and it's also important that we find a team that are the 11. You understand what I mean? Instead of we are switching a lot of players all the time, that's also very difficult for a team, that new players come in and players go out all the time. But yeah, I think for us it's very important that we have experienced the first half of the season, and now we only have to be positive, for sure.
Now we have six big clubs ahead, starting with FC Bayern. In the first half of the season, we gained 0 points from these six games. How much points will we get this time?
I would say we'll get points in all of them, because it would be stupid of me to say that we won't get any points because we didn't get it the first time. Of course, it's difficult games. We are playing against some players who have tried something crazy in their entire career, and they are for sure big players. But for us, it's also important that we keep positive and we concentrate about ourselves. What can we do better? What can we do better? Defense, offense, whatsoever. And we have seen that it's possible to beat them, even if Bayern or Dortmund also, there's in a bad period right now. So we have to be positive, we have to stay strong together, and then everything is possible.
Let's have a short look on last Sunday's game that did not happen. Mm-hmm. How was the day for you players, for you in personal? How was the morning? When did you get the message that the game won't happen? And what did you do the rest of the day?
I went to bed and I was looking out of the window because my girlfriend told me that there would come a lot of snow, and I was looking outside and I was thinking, oh, it can't be because there's no snow right now, only a little bit. But when I woke up the morning and saw how much snow there was coming through in the night, I was thinking, wow. And then I prepared in the morning like always. I went out with my dog, prepared my breakfast and went down to the club. And when I came down there, I could see there was a lot of snow on the pitches. And there I knew we won't train like we should supposed to do. We should train in the morning and then went to the hotel afterwards. And then everyone was coming into the dressing room. Some was a bit late also because of the weather. It was very difficult to arrive there. And then they said there was a small chance that we wouldn't play. And then the coach, he said shortly that it wasn't possible for us to go to Fell, I think, to the hotel because of the snow and that would be too dangerous. And we couldn't go home, so we had to stay in the training ground, and then we had to see what's going on. And then we got the message that 11:30 we would get the first message I can't remember the name of it. They would call them and say if it was possible or no because of the pitches. And then we got the message in the end where they were telling us it wasn't possible for us to play. And then we already ordered some food, so we ate some food together and went home. So it was, there wasn't so much to say. Of course, it was really annoying that you couldn't play because you, in your mind, you would play for sure, but that's how it is sometimes.
Did you already had this in your career before?
Not that I can remember, because in Denmark there can also be a lot of snow, and there was one time there was that much snow but we still played the game, but it was good we didn't play because it's a lot of snow everywhere. It's not a good thing. A lot of injuries can happen there with a pitch that's very slippery. The ball won't do the thing you normally want to do with it, so I think the thing was good that we cancelled the game.
Let's have a look at the next game. We play in Munich against the current Champions League champion FC Bayern Munich. They play the World Cup final today in Qatar. They have three games this week. They had Bundesliga on Friday, so we have 2 hours, 2 weeks break, and they have they are full in progress. What do you think? Who has the better? Who has the advantage for Monday?
I think they will have, because they are playing at their home pitch. It's Bayern Munich we are speaking about. So, but I would prefer to have three games than have 2 weeks off, because you don't touch the ball that much. They're in a good game mood right now. So who will have the advantage? We will see on Monday who has the advantage and who will win the game. Hopefully it will be us, and that's what I'm thinking about. I don't want to think how many games they have or so on. Right now for us it's so important that we're thinking about ourselves. What can we do better? And when we are losing, it's also important that we stay together and stay strong together, because that we need it. We need it for the rest of the season, and we need it also to be in the end that we can say we're safe. Now we will stay in the first league, and that's the main thing for us for sure.
Okay, so let's start on Monday with some points in Munich.
That would be crazy. For sure.
Thank you, Berit.
Yeah, you're welcome.